remember last month we talked about Resto Mods. Resto Mods is a vehicle that's old, but it's been restored in a way that makes it very drivable. Modern upgrades like the transmission and the motor and even air conditioning. This week we're going to talk about hot rods. Now, when you say the word hot rod, people envision every old car being a hot rod. That's not necessarily the case. Hot rods, in my opinion, are this. They actually started after World War II. They started when the guys came back from the war and they didn't have anything to do. You know, I'm not going to give you a history lesson, but the guys left and the ladies stayed and built the airplanes and the guns and the ammo that we used. Rosie the Riveter, that's where that came from. And when the guys came home, man, there was kind of a lack of jobs, so they had a lot of spare time. So what they did was they invented a lot of stuff. They invented the hot rod and they invented the chopper. The chopper's a motorcycle. Now, in my opinion, choppers and cars and hot rods, they're all the same. So today's show, we're going to talk about hot rods. We're going to talk about my truck, the Beast. We're going to go back there and take a look at it, and we're even going to go for a ride. And then when we get done taking that for a test drive, we're going to take a look at some hot rod bikes. If you remember last month, we featured the 550 project, and I mentioned that we had a Zombie Slayer in the works. Well, guess what? We've got the Zombie Slayer done. It's a little insane, but it is a hot rod motorcycle, and I'm going to bring that to you today. So let's go out back and take a look at a hot rod truck. Sound like a plan?
One day I devised...
Snap on.
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry. Cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself...
What I want to bring you guys this month is something that's called a hot rod. A lot of people look at just any car and say, well, that's a hot rod. And that's okay. But a true hot rod is this. A hot rod is a vehicle that people cut parts off of, changed parts, worked on their cars every week so that on the weekend their cars are faster. And then next week they'd work on it all week. They'd be back at the drag strip or the racetrack again on the weekend. Now let me, I picked my own truck just as an example because this truck has evolved and has changed through the years. Everybody looks at this truck and says, well, it's a Ford. Well, you're right, it's a Ford. But it's got a menagerie of parts. To me, a hot rod, it evolves with the personality of the guy that owns it. You know, for example, my truck, the top is chopped, the door's open backwards. It's a little bit on the rough side. And that's me, I'm a little rough cut. I've heard stories of guys building hot rods. Back in the day, they would take an A model car and they'd stuff a Cadillac motor in it and a Lincoln transmission. There's even country songs written about this stuff.
Well, it's a 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59 automobile.
This particular truck is a Ford and it looks like a Ford, but underneath it's got parts from God knows whatever I can scrounge up. For example, the side rails of the bed are actually a Chevrolet. The reason these Chevrolet beds were used is that a Ford bed comes up real high. If you take a look at this truck at a distance, it's got a real low profile. Well, if it had the Ford bed on it, well, it'd look a mile taller. So with the Chevy bed on it, it looks chopped. Now, the top of the truck has been cut. So in other words, this truck has been cut and the roof has been lowered. This is called chopped. Makes the back window shorter, gives it a lower stance in the whole thing. The truck's been channeled, so the floorboard has been raised and the truck sunk down over the frame. Now, a lot of cool things go into a hot rod. For example, a lot of personal taste goes into a hot rod. My wife can attest to this one. But these street signs, it was an idea I had, and my wife says, well, where are we going to get them? Well, I'm not going to tell you where we got them. If anyone asked, they came with the truck. The beer keg is the gas tank of the truck. A lot of people look and say, what do you got a beer keg in your truck for? Well, that's the gas can. Now keep in mind, hot rods have a lot of personality. This particular beer keg was a keg that was drank by a good friend of mine when he came home from the war in Afghanistan. So that that keg of beer was drank to celebrate him coming home. The tailgate is hand-built. All of this metal's been cut out by hand. The tail lights, I've got little skulls on the tail lights. All a personal thing. From the truck being channeled and lowered to the beer keg to the street signs. And another cool thing about the truck is that the doors open backwards. I did that because it's just wrong. You know, doors are not supposed to open backwards on a truck. The front end tilts forward. It's a menagerie of parts from Chevrolet and Ford, and it's just a mixture of everything that, to me, makes the true hot rod. I can't tell you how many times someone has walked up to my truck at a car show, and I say, "That's okay, get in it and sit down," and they grab the door handle. The door handle doesn't even work, but it's wrong. It's just wrong. So some of the things I do to my personal stuff is just, it's just wrong. It's different. The license plates that are inside the truck. If you notice, I don't run a real license plate on my truck. There's a 1954 tag on the back of my truck. There is no up-to-date modern Georgia tag. And that's, you know, that's something people should know that own collector cars. In the state of Georgia, if you own a 54 Ford truck, which that's what the beast is a 54 Ford truck, and you can locate a 1954 Georgia tag, you can take that tag to the registration department and register your truck with an antique tag, and that's what I've done. If you take a look at the interior, there's actually a big hole in the seat. And that's just wrong. You know, you build a nice vehicle, something that's fast and quick, and you know, you think you'd put some good upholstery in it, but that's just the way the seat came out of the junkyard. So, I mean, it is what it is. The steering column's out of a Chevrolet Camaro. It does have power steering and power brakes. And the truck's pretty quick. We'll take a look under the hood. The hood of this truck in 1954, and it's a 54 Ford, would have opened conventionally like a normal vehicle, but I thought that was wrong. So what I decided to do was make the whole front of the truck tilt open. Now you guys are getting to see something that I really don't let a lot of folks look. I just, you know, I had a guy back here a while ago, a potential customer. He says, "What kind of motor's in it?" And I said, "Well, you know, it's top secret." Well, to me, it is. In the hot rod world, these guys would work on their cars all week, and during the weekend, they'd bring it to the drag strip, and you very seldom got to see what they was running. You know, it was just a secret, you know? Make it go faster from one day to the other. The transmission in it is a 4-speed, so that truck's got overdrive. I can put the truck on the interstate and cruise 85 miles an hour all day long. You just don't think of those things being in an old beater-type truck. I don't have side windows in that truck. So if you get caught in the rain, you're gonna get wet. So nothing rolls up, nothing rolls down, they're just not there. But like I say, I'm a little rough cut for my personal stuff. That's just the image I like. I like the way that stuff looks. We're gonna go take a look at the Impala we started, I guess it was back during the first episode.
Experts in packing, taking care of your mail and printing documents. So small business owners feel anything but small.
Hey, we do a lot more than shipping.
Visit any of our 3 convenient Henry County locations.
For more than 100 years, Woodward Academy has fostered excellence, character, and opportunity. From pre-K to 12th grade, Woodward offers a more complete approach to education. Woodward Academy, excellence, character, and opportunity. Visit us today.
Before I started Taekwondo, I used to be really shy, and whenever I'd have to talk in front of the class, you could barely hear me, I'd be really nervous. But since I've started with the ATA and the leadership classes, I can talk in front of the class, and it's helped.
For Amber, the one thing she lacked was discipline, and I think it's helped her a lot in that area. That translates to having a similar focus in school. She's at the top of her class at a lot of things.
What makes these kids extraordinary? The answer is, they are regular kids who achieved extraordinary things just because they tried. All you need to do is try. Detroit ATA.
Call 770-320-7206 and receive 5 classes for $55, plus a free uniform.
Party tonight, and I have nothing to accessorize.
Well, let's see what we can do. Let's try this ring on.
It's nice, but I don't know if it's just right.
Well, let's try these. Whoa, how did that get in there?
Visit us at the corner of Hudson Bridge and Flippin Road in the Kroger Shopping Center,
where we can make you look like $1 million.
Hi, I'm Steve Thomas. For years, you've seen me building and renovating houses on television, and now I'm working with Habitat for Humanity. Why? Because I deeply believe in Habitat's vision, a world in which everyone has a decent place to live. And the Habitat for Humanity Restore helps us make that happen.
Habitat Restores are nonprofit home improvement stores and donation centers that sell new and gently used furniture, home accessories, building materials, and appliances to the public at a fraction of the retail price.
And soon, we're having a Habitat Restore grand opening near you. But to make that happen, we need your stuff.
Whether you're remodeling, redecorating, or just cleaning out your storage space, we'll be glad to take that extra stuff off your hands. You get to free up space, and we get to raise more money to build more Habitat homes.
So to help us turn your household items into more Habitat homes, drop them by our donation center, or just give us a call and we'll pick them up.
It's a farm where you take berries from the bush to the ice cream bowl with a little fun mixed in between.
It's an outdoor nature adventure with your kids that they will relive with theirs one day.
It's a family excursion through a wild animal safari right in your own backyard.
It's the corporate retreat where you're in the driver's seat. It's an evening out with a few friends, or a night of speed with a few thousand friends.
It's Henry County, comfortably south of Atlanta.
Oh, the grill looks good, don't it, Tommy? Joe's the rookie. I asked him, I says, are you getting any girlfriends from the TV shows? Are you?
Yes, sir.
He tells everybody he's on TV now.
Sure do.
That ain't working for me. What's up with that?
You got a wife.
It don't hurt to have a girlfriend.
So after the first episode, I told Tommy, did you go home and tell your wife you're on TV, Tommy?
What? I went home, about to play like I was Brad Pitt. Try to stir up something new.
So Joe's getting girlfriends. Tommy's made his wife happy again by being on TV, and Stanley just wants to watch all of it.
I'm old.
When it comes to my guys, they're all have their areas of expertise. There's nothing Stanley, the old man, can't do. He's truly a craftsman, and it shows. If you guys remember a few months ago, it may have been episode one, we had this car sitting in the same shop. It was ready to go to the paint booth. Since then, 2 months have gone by, and we've got it painted. All of the chrome has been sent out to the polishers. If you take a look at all the chrome going around the fenders and all the trim around the hood, all that's been polished out. Even though it's a 1974 car, it was painted a 2011 BMW color, which to me, I think, makes the car stand out good. That car belongs to Albert. That was his grandfather's car. So there's a story behind every car. You just got to dig and find it. He inherited that car and had us refinish it. Now, Albert actually lives quite a ways away. He lives almost in Alabama. He came that far to have us restore his car because of the passion we have for him and the end result. Now, if you take a look at that car today, it's beautiful. All that chrome work refinished, the paint is slick as glass, and that color. Albert is a BMW mechanic, works at a BMW dealership. That's a BMW color on that Impala. We're really getting close to finishing this car. Tommy has just put in the windshield. He's working on the back glass. Stanley has spent, you've probably spent, what, 2 days putting the trim back together. We're probably another day away and the car should be trimmed out, but it's coming along real nice. All of the soft seals in the doors and windows have been replaced. So the doors open and close like they did the day it was new. Of course, the car's, you know, still dusty and dirty. But as far as the fitment goes, it's fantastic. Closes like the day it did when it was new. Probably better than the day it was new. It won't be long now. We'll be getting the bumpers back from chrome. All in all, it's a nice project. The level of passion and concern that goes into these cars here at Campbell's Customs is, I think we're second to none. I believe in my guys. I believe in what we do. Listen, I tell you what, Stanley, if you'll get the beast out and get it warmed up, we're going to go back up the front office, get a cup of coffee. You've already got your coffee. And we'll go for a test ride in the beast and see what we can. We'll stir up some leaves on the asphalt. How about that?
Sounds good.
The relationship with Heritage Bank and the people goes back some time. We have to have flexibility and support from our bank, and that's what we have.
The situation with Heritage is they are so uniquely different than all the other banks. They're probably the premier community bank there is anywhere in the country.
It doesn't matter what time of day you go into the bank, Heritage Bank, the people are just wonderful.
I opened a business account with Heritage Bank, and it's just been a great relationship. The bankers are just friendly, and it takes a partnership. And with that partnership, my business accounts have grown, and I hope they continue to grow with Heritage.
Come out to Nash Farm on February 8th at 9 a.m. for the second annual Hot Chocolate 5K and 10K. Bring canned goods for the Helping in His Name food pantry and help yourself to the chocolate treats being offered on race day. Go to GetSetGrow.com for more information and register on Eventbrite.com.
Your smile is important to us. Here at the Cosmetic and Restorative Practice of Dr. Linda King, we specialize in personalized custom care to help you achieve a beautiful, healthy smile with the most gentle methods. We customize a treatment plan especially for you. And from your first phone call, we want to create a relationship of trust and confidence in our staff and our techniques.
So call today to be on your way to a beautiful new smile.
Join us at beautiful Stone Mountain Park for the annual Livy's Love 5K and 8K Fun Run and Walk on Saturday, January 18th. The race begins at 8 a.m. Proceeds benefit Livy's Love Children's Assistance Foundation. For more information or to register, visit GetSetGrow.com.
What's Massage Envy? For me, it's the quickest,
healthiest way to get over long hours, paperwork,
stress, piles and piles of stress.
Gone, just like that.
For me, it's why I still love this.
This. All of this.
With convenient hours in over 600 locations, you can relieve stress, aches, and pains on your schedule. Start a healthier routine today for just $49.
Go. You'll see.
At Massage Envy.
How about Monday? Can you call us on Monday? No, bring it in on Monday. I'm thinking Monday will be good.
Is it okay that Corey Pratt brings his car today?
No, today. No, not over the weekend.
We don't want it over the weekend.
I don't want anything sitting over the weekend.
We don't want things sitting over the weekend.
The Zombie Slayer has been a dream of mine for at least a couple of years. I have so many projects that I personally want to do. The Mega Beast, the 56 Ford is the next one. The Zombie Slayer was one that I just could never seem to make it happen. I'm a Harley guy. The Zombie Slayer is a Honda until I met Chuck. Chuck was so passionate about what he does with Hondas. I said, that's it. This is the guy that can help my dream come true, the Zombie Slayer. Let me tell you something about the bike. When I told Chuck about doing the Zombie Slayers, Chuck was like, "Yeah, let's do it." But what are we gonna, what's gonna make it stand out different? I told Chuck, I said, "Man, I think it'd be cool if we use rebar. Rebar's tough, rugged." Chuck got on board, says, "Yeah, we can use the rebar." And my intention was Harley. Chuck says, "Nah, let's do the Honda."
Got to have a Honda. I mean, hey, it's a bike you want to get away from zombies on.
Well, that's true. When I came up with the Zombie Slayer idea, I wanted it fast and nimble. Well, Chuck's design plays right into that. Just like the 550 project, which is sitting in the background, Chuck built us a custom chassis to start with. Chuck, if you want to explain what the chassis and where we went with that.
This 650, it started out as a swing arm bike. Shocks would have been mounted right in here. All that Honda stuff, from the factory, we cut off the back half and fabricated one of our rigid tail sections.
It being a hot rod or a chopper, as we chop parts off, and if you'll notice on the ground, all the parts are laying on the ground with it. So the shocks and struts and swing arm Chuck's talking about is just laying right there.
There's pieces of it right here.
Another thing we did was I told Chuck about the rebar idea. I said, building the brake pedal, building the foot pegs, no big deal. But Chuck, can you build a sissy bar out of rebar? His dad, Dan, had another bike sitting on the bench beside it. I said, see that sissy bar? See how it's kind of blocked off? Can you build me one like that?
I said, sure, I'll build you one like that. And,
I said, Chuck, build me a nice squared off rebar, sissy bar, and what happened, Chuck?
He said, tweak it a little bit, and it obviously got tweaked a lot.
All the parts that we could possibly build, we built out of rebar. When you think of something that's tough, you think of rebar. Man, it holds concrete together. So the sissy bar, the back fender strut, the foot pegs, the brake pegs, even the handlebar stabilizer, the front fenders, built out of rebar. I came to a dilemma with the handlebars. I said, Chuck, I want handlebars to be different different than a street bike. Chuck says, hold on a minute. And he disappeared and went to the junkyard. He drug in a set of handlebars off of a dirt bike. Now, they're not mounted like dirt bike handlebars. John Deere tractor LED headlights, John Deere tractor seat. Who would have thought to put a tractor seat on a motorcycle? You think it's uncomfortable? You know what? It's actually very comfortable. It's big. You know, some of these choppers have little bitty seats. That hurts. This big tractor seat feels pretty good. And I watch the zombie movies and I think, yeah, man, you got to have some way to protect yourself, right? So why not add some throwing stars, a machete, a knife on the handlebars, and what else? A 12-gauge shotgun.
You got about everything you need but Twinkies.
Everything but Twinkies. Check out the LED lights. You know, everybody says the zombie stuff's green, so we installed some green LED lights on it. Even fashioned a front fender that a rebar that definitely could impel a zombie at 60 miles an hour. We put some neon lights on it for show. Yeah, we did a fantastic paint job. Chasten, I'm going to tell you what, I wish he was here today. He's not. He's gone off to Tennessee to do some pinstriping job. But the artwork he put on the side of that zombie slayer is just off the chain.
A lot of people think that's a sticker. No, that's Chasten.
When it comes to a hot rod, whether it be my old truck, a hot rod, or a motorcycle, a hot rod, it's a dream thing for me. It was a dream to build this bike. And I also wanted to instill in building this bike the next generation of builders. When you think about going to a car show or a bike show, man, you see all adults. Man, at Campbell's Customs, the kids get involved. Let me introduce you to my stepson, Landon.
My son, Charlie.
Charlie. And both of those boys had a hand in this bike. On all those Saturdays that we were working on the bike, Charlie was right in the middle of it. You could not keep his hands off of it. Landon got down here in the floor with me, helped me put on the latest LEDs. Hey, Charlie, could you turn them on for us? What about the headlights, man? See, man, they even know what to do when it comes to zombie slaying. So it's kind of like a dream come true, and Chuck helped me achieve that dream. But that's not it, man. We already started another bike. Yeah, you guys wait to see this one. So maybe about March we'll have that bike done. We built the Zombie Slayer in a month, which is kind of record speed for a total build. But I think the craftsmanship works. Listen, you guys check us out at the Great American Motorcycle Show the end of this month. We'll be up in, is that in Norcross, Chuck?
Yes, sir. It's in Norcross off Indian Trail, I believe.
We'll have both these bikes on display. You can come check them out. Chuck and I spent virtually every Saturday, late nights, just him and I hammering on this bike. So, but the results are, to me, is just, I don't think there's anything else out there like it.